Hi, my name is Charlie from the Royal Parks Mission Invertebrate, a project helping people to discover, celebrate and protect the important invertebrates who call London's Royal Parks home. This video is all about hoverflies and how you can create a simple habitat called a hoverfly lagoon.
Hoverflies are important pollinators, helping to spread pollen as they move from flower to flower looking for nectar to drink. They are masters of mimicry, often with striking patterns on their bodies to fool predators into thinking that they might be a bee or a wasp. But hoverflies can't sting you. We have over 280 species of hoverfly in the UK, and some of these species need watery habitats for the larvae, the baby hoverflies, to live in. The life cycle of these species starts off with an egg. A female can lay over 200 eggs at a time. Out of the eggs hatch the larvae. These ones are called long-tailed larvae, and it's this life stage that lives in water. That long tail is actually a breathing tube that extends out from the larva's bottom. They use this breathing tube like a snorkel, which sticks out of the surface of the water while the rest of the body is submerged and feeding. Once they get a bit bigger, the larvae crawl out of the water to find a dry patch to pupate in. The pupa is a bit like a butterfly's cocoon, and inside the shell of the pupa, it develops and changes its body. Then, when it's ready, out will emerge the adult hoverfly to feed on nectar and find a mate. Female hoverflies will look for rot holes in trees or boggy conditions to lay her eggs in. But these conditions can be hard to find in tidy gardens. And that is where you come in. I'll tell you how to get involved with the Hoverfly Lagoons project and show you how you can create a simple habitat using easy to find materials. To make our lagoons, we will need a milk bottle, a pair of scissors, a pen, some vegetation to put inside the lagoon. So cut grass works well, or I'm using dead leaves. Then we'll need some additional dead leaves, some sticks, a seed tray or a large punnet with drainage holes in, and access to water. Firstly, cut the milk bottle in half, just below the handle, and we're going to use this bottom half. Carefully use a pen to poke about 4 holes in the sides of the container, about 2.5 centimeters below the cup edge. This will allow water to drain out so the lagoon doesn't overfill. Add the grass or the leaves up to the line of the holes. You need to fill it with a lot of vegetation, so make sure to compress it down as you're filling up the lagoon. All of this vegetation that we're adding now will start to be broken down by microbes in the lagoon. And it's these microbes that the larvae will feed on. Then we want to add a thick layer of dry leaves all the way up to the brim. This layer will act as a landing pad for females so they can rest and lay their eggs. And then, when the eggs hatch, the larvae will crawl through the leaves and into the water. Insert some long sticks that reach from the bottom of the bottle and stick out to the top. This will act like a larval ladder, helping the larvae to climb out of their lagoon to find a space to pupate. Next, fill the container up with water up to where we've made those holes. Finally, place the entire container in the centre of the tray and fill the tray with more dry leaves. The drainage holes at the bottom of this tray will help the leaves to stay dry. This tray of dry leaves will be the perfect space for the pupae. That completes our hoverfly lagoon. In time, female hoverflies will visit and lay their eggs, and soon we'll have lots of long-tailed larvae in our lagoon. The Hoverfly Lagoons project is run by the Buzz Club at the University of Sussex, and they are looking for volunteer citizen scientists to create lagoons and send in information about the number of larvae and pupae using their lagoons. This will help scientists to find out which species are using the lagoons and how to create the best lagoons for them.
So not only will you be creating habitat, the hoverflies you attract will help to pollinate our plants. You'll be doing some amazing science and you get to see these fantastic life cycles up close. Thanks for watching. Don't forget we've got loads of invertebrate activities and ways you can help wildlife on the Mission Invertebrate website and on our social media.